Hello everyone and welcome back to
The Washington Way.
So we got a request from one of our subscribers to do a video that talked about every phase of our relationship. The dating phase, the courting phase, engagement phase, marriage phase, and now parenthood. As most of you know, if you've been following us, if not, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share any video of ours that you like.
All that.
We greatly appreciate it. We're on the road to 1K.
Yep. Slowly but surely getting there.
Yeah. We will be honest and admit that over the past year or so, since wedding planning, we kind of fell off, but we've been trying to get back into it. We're first-time parents, and listen, it is not for the weak.
At all.
Our baby girl, Jay, look at the picture I just put in. She's so cute, isn't she? Little girl Jay is something else. She's already rolling over.
3 months now.
My birthday was June 16th. Happy 30th to me. And on my birthday, Jay sent me a video of her holding her freaking bottle. Like, 3 months holding a bottle. She just turned 3 months on the 14th. Like, that is unheard of. As my mom would say, these pandemic babies is something else.
Different.
But where do we want to start? So,
let's start off with, I guess, how we met.
Yeah. So we both went to Florida State University.
Yep.
I graduated the spring of 2015, and I met Jay that summer.
Literally, that summer. So I graduated that fall of 2015. Mm-hmm. So first off, I'm from Jacksonville, Florida.
And then I'm from Lakeland, Florida.
So we met in a club, actually. What's crazy is my homeboy was like, hey, bro, you trying to go out? It's a club called Recess in Tallahassee. It's a rooftop club. So I was just like, you know, I had a whole bunch of classes in the summer. So I was like, I don't know. Actually, the semester was over.
Yeah.
So it was in between semesters, but I was just like, I don't know if I want to go out. And he was like, bruh, just come with me. So we randomly went out that night. I don't even think I had like anything swaggy. Or I just think I came in.
And let me specify, us meeting in the club sound just a tad bit ratchet. It was a graduation party. So it was a graduation party for the people who graduated in spring for the summer.
Yeah.
And Recess was
a rooftop venue.
No, it wasn't. That was joint was packed. You sleep.
It was dead. No, I promise you.
I promise you it wasn't.
Because I
Recess
literally saw you.
So big.
I saw you walk past.
It wasn't dead. I promise you. Recess is like, it's a really nice venue, but it's small.
Yeah.
So it wasn't dead again because it's small, but it's really nice. So I just wanted to clarify that because that sounds so right.
Actually, let's take it back before that. I actually got her number before that night.
Yeah.
So we followed each other on Snapchat.
Okay.
So I got her number on Snapchat. So she used to always cook. And me as a person, my mama could really cook. So if anybody cooked close to my mama, you know, I try to see if they can match. So she posted something, and I was just like, man, when you gonna make me a plate? And she was like, I'll make you a plate. And then I was like, man, let me get your number. So I got a number, and we probably text once.
Yeah.
We probably text once, but nothing of it. We didn't really think nothing of it. I've seen her on the sidelines before, like during the football games, like while we warming up and stuff.
And we ironically was a part of the same organization called Dream.
Mm-hmm.
But we were there at
different times. Yeah. So we in Recess and I'm just chilling with my homeboy and one of our homegirls is with us too. And I seen her walk past and I'm like, dang, I ain't seen her like in person in a minute. So I had, you know, grabbed her wrist and then she like turned around. I was like, what's up? So she literally started dancing on me.
It was a song that came on. Let's not, mind you, again, I had just graduated. I was a little tip-tip.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, a little song came on. Hey, Jermaine, how you doing? How you been doing? Blah, blah, blah. It was like one of those kind of things.
And if you haven't been through college, like, usually people try to find a little summer boo during that time. And I was like, I need to find me a little summer boo. You know, I'm going to be up here working and stuff like that. So I was like, man, what's up? So she was like, I was like, I got your number. And she was like, how you got my number? I was like, watch. So I typed in her number. I was like, that's your number, right? She was like, yeah. I was like, I'm going to hit you up and I'm going to tell you about what happened. And the next day, I FaceTimed her. She ain't answer. So she texted. She was like, who is this? I was like, this Jermaine.
No, that's not how it went.
What, how it went?
You texted me and was like, this is Jermaine. I told you I was going to call you about and tell you about how was acting.
Well, she was at work. So she worked at Steak and Shake. So she worked late night shifts at Steak and Shake. So I FaceTimed. I was like, man, you was wild last night. Like, you just randomly started dancing on me. So we had like short conversation, and then probably the next day you was like, you gonna come over after you got off work.
Yeah, it was a lot going on that summer. We had crossed paths a few times. I think the Sigmas had a house party.
Yeah.
The Alphas had their barbecue that they usually have during the summer. So we had crossed paths and stuff that whole summer.
So then she came over probably the next day after she got off at like 5 a.m. So we end up taking a walk through where I used to live at in University Green.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, she asked me, like, you know, what's my inspiration, like, what I want to do, basically trying to get the feel of me. So at the time, I was just telling her, like, you know, I'm trying to graduate, trying to get a job in tech, you know, I'm real focused. And, you know, she told me that she's about to be a nutritionist. She's about to move. I think you moved back home to work, right?
Yeah, I moved back home a couple. Because if you know, during the summer, that lease for new, what is it, July?
Mm-hmm.
You got to re-sign that lease in July. So I had actually moved home in July. And I started working in Florida for almost 2 years.
Yeah.
And we were still talking then for 2 years. Then after that, I went to grad school in Alabama for a year and a half.
You're moving too fast, bro. Oh,
okay.
So circle back. Boom. She was in Tallahassee. And then, you know, once we went on that walk, we kind of like, you know, like, okay.
It was a mutual understanding that we're just friends. Yeah. This is just a little summer thing, you know, don't make nothing out of it. And, you know, that's one of the things that attracted me to Jermaine initially. He wasn't one of those guys who was being cheesy. You know how guys could be cheesy in college, just trying to act like, pretty much telling you what you want to hear. He was honest, you know. He was real cool.
I still actually have our first video when she came over that morning. I ended up falling asleep, and she recorded me, which is hilarious because that video is what, almost 10 years old now?
Yeah,
which is crazy.
It is so funny. Jermaine was so patient with me. Again, it was the summer. I had just graduated. What was nuts is that I didn't think that I was about to graduate because I was, like, retaking a class for, like, the third time. So I was just super excited that I was getting past that milestone and actually about to start my adult life for real, for real. And I went to a party and got so faded. Or was that that wasn't the same night. And I came over to Jermaine's house, and when I tell you, I puked all over his bathroom. And he was so, you don't remember that?
Oh yeah, I do remember that.
He was so mad, and I could tell
I ain't even help her.
You helped me.
No, I didn't.
You helped me, but I could tell in his face that he was just like, oh my gosh, she's sloppy. Like, what
first
is
of
this?
All, I don't like when people throw up. Like, yeah. I haven't thrown up in like 10, 15 years. So for somebody to come in my bathroom and throw up, I'm just
that
like,
he
man.
Barely knew, and it was a hot ghetto mess. And I felt terrible when I actually sobered up because I'm just like, this not even me. Like, what is going on?
So she actually took me on my first date.
Yeah.
I definitely was broke. I think I just got my internship that summer, but I haven't got paid yet.
Mm. But, and it was just this wing spot called Hobbit Hoagies in Tallahassee. It was, you know, just a little 1-2 date.
Yeah.
But,
and then we had a date at Genghis Grill, which, for those that don't know, it's kind of like a
It's like one of those hibachi buffets mm-hmm. where you get a bowl and then you put your protein in and you get your vegetables and then they stir fry it with everybody else's. It's real good.
So we went through the summer, you know, talking, as mm-hmm. they say.
Yeah.
We was talking and it was time for her to go back to Lakeland and I was staying in Tallahassee because I had my last semester. So basically, we was kind of like long distance talking, as mm-hmm. you would say.
Let me tell y'all how wild I was. Like, how
she
I
was
knew.
Trying to maim me. She definitely was trying to maim me. And I'm just like, look, I gotta graduate.
I did maim you. I cut all of my dudes off of you just to test the waters. I cut most of my dudes off of you just to test the waters.
Listen, I told her what my plan was. I'm just like, I gotta stay focused. Like, I knew. I had a goal in mind, and I had to make sure I get that goal before I commit to somebody. So we end up talking, and then she ended up coming for my graduation in December.
Yeah.
So she came to my graduation. This was the first time she was about to meet my mama. So she was like, your mama coming? I was like, yeah. So I'm like, I'm not going to introduce you. I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
No, he hadn't told his mama about me. That's what it was.
I did.
So when she walked up in his room, she looked at like, who is this hoochie? And so I just like, I felt so trash because yeah. I like, bro, really? Wait.
Yeah. I was trash. I was trash.
He was trash.
I can admit that. I just wasn't, because me before talking to her, I didn't have a girlfriend since high school. So I was single all my college years. So that was 4 years.
Well, you was talking, rather. You won't say you was single.
But yeah, talking, but I didn't have no official. Yeah. Anybody that met my mama, okay, you know, it's serious. But she came to my graduation. She actually drove down and had to drive back. Mm-hmm. Why did you have to drive back? You had some event or something yeah. like that. So she came to the graduation.
Probably something with dance.
Yeah, she came to the graduation. And then really after graduation, I found out, well, before graduation, I found out that I was moving to Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And then basically we just.
No, fast forward. You interviewed in 3 different places.
Okay, yes, I did
interview.
Atlanta, yeah,
Tampa, because he came down to me.
Yeah.
No, he came down to Tampa.
Yeah.
And that was the first time I told you I loved you in Tampa.
Oh, yeah, she did. And I was like, I didn't know how to take it at first. I was just like. And then she was like, you know, love me. And I was just like, I love you. But it was so unexpected because it was like, dang, she loved me. Okay. I love her. And then we went from there. So after that, I moved to Atlanta. Yeah. She was in Lakeland. I want to say we did long distance for
3 years.
3 years.
3 years.
So you were in Lakeland, you were in Alabama, mm-hmm. and then what, 2018?
Yeah, it was about 2018.
Yeah, so I moved to Atlanta in 2016, and 2018, like November, I want to say, mm-hmm. she moved to Atlanta with me, and we were staying in an apartment.
And we technically were still long distance then because I did my nutrition internship,
mm-hmm.
which I did between Florida and Georgia. So I was in Florida for, went back to Florida for quite a bit of time to do some rotations in Florida. And then I did some in Georgia too because I had to find preceptors and stuff and it was really hard. So I had to get in where I fit in and mm-hmm. I had some connections in Florida. So I just did that. So.
And she was kind of against like, shacking up, yeah. as the old people say. She didn't want to move in without a ring. And I'm just like, you know, we kind of got to feel each other out. Because, like, you know, what happens if we live together all of a sudden? I don't even know who the person is I'm living with. Because yeah. you turn to a whole completely person. Or you might not like something I do. So I think that definitely helped in our relationship as far as living together.
Yeah. And as they say, you know, looking for different red flags and stuff in a relationship. At that point, I completely trust Jermaine and I knew what his intentions was mm-hmm. for the relationship. There was no red flags as far as him not wanting to be with me and just playing that I saw.
Yeah, actually, let me rewind it. I made it official February 15th of 2016. So That was like a month after I started my first job. She, I flew out. We got flewed out to Atlanta. We went to Stone Mountain and we went to Cheesecake Factory. And that's when I asked her to officially be my girlfriend. Mm-hmm. And then after that, we just kept going from there.
Yeah.
And then
made trips to see each other and then took some trips in between.
I think that's what really helped us out a lot. We made sure that we saw each other like at least every 2 months, 2 to 3 months. Mm-hmm. So she would drive down sometimes or I would come down there to see her or in Alabama. Yeah, we're planning trips and we had vacations together. Mm-hmm. I think our first vacation was a cruise to the Bahamas. We went to the Bahamas, Turks and Caicos,
New Orleans.
Yeah, we went to New Orleans,
Jamaica.
So once she moved in 2018 November, I actually started looking for a ring. I was like, okay, it's been what, almost 3 years. I was like, it's time for us to make it official.
Yeah.
So while she was living with me, I actually went to go look for a ring. I went to Hillsburg, got a custom ring. You see it. So I went there, spent about 2 hours looking for a ring, on the phone with her mama, my mama, her friends, my friends, to make sure that, you know, this is the right ring. So I actually surprised her with a surprise engagement party in Jacksonville. Got her good. I was like, okay.
But before that, we went to Dubai.
Yeah, we what's crazy is this time, the time of our engagement, so much was happening.
Yes, it was.
My friend, Garrett, one of our close friends, he proposed to his now wife literally 2 weeks before I did. We went to church the weekend, the next day, and somebody proposed. So I'm just like, bro, y'all about to let the cat out the bag. So in Dubai, I knew that I was going to propose. So it was just like, you know, the topping on the cake. We went way out the country to a different
top three trips.
Yeah, it was definitely lit.
Yeah.
So I did a surprise engagement party in Jacksonville. Had all my friends and family, her friends and family, and we dressed it up like it was my sister's birthday, because March 24th is my sister's birthday, and we had got engaged on March 30th. Mm-hmm. So it was a masquerade party. Everybody was fresh, and went ahead and dropped on that one knee. So once we got engaged, you know, nothing really changed, because, you know, we love each other, we know that we want to go the long distance, and we just went through life. Of course, you know, she wanted kids.
What? Yeah, okay, so you know what? We'll do this as a two-part series, because this is already about 20 minutes long.
Yeah.
But we hope that gave y'all enough information. If it's anything more personal or detailed you want us to add, go ahead. We're open books to a certain extent.
Yeah, so the next video we'll do the leading up to marriage.
Yeah. Get a little bit more personal.
Currently marriage. Because we've been married for a year now. And we have a baby.
Yeah. So we'll do all that in part two.
Yep.
Again, if it's anything specific you want us to tell you in that video, let us know and we'll spill the tea.
Yes, sir.
Thank y'all for watching again. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.